We're here at the Snapple Theater Center for the press event for Ghetto Klown, directed by Fisher Stevens and starring John Leguizamo. You guys have both had long careers, both on film and on stage.
What are you trying to say? We're old? What is
it?
No,
yeah. It's okay. We are old.
Yeah, we are. It's true. Get over it.
We're old.
What inspired you to start work on this new show?
I started performing at colleges, and I used to get crazy drunk before and during and talk about these things where I normally would not talk about. They were loving it, and I started typing it down, and I ended up with this show. That's the genesis. On Guinness, the Guinness Genesis.
We met
in Midsummer Night's Dream
at the Public Theater. And John put itching powder in my
I was parked.
And Shakespeare's hard enough, but then during the show. So then I destroyed his dressing room. I took a whole can of Barbasol shaving cream. We were troublemakers.
So I knew that Fisher was perfect to direct my show because he's known me since then. We did Super Mario Brothers, another genius piece of work. So he was the perfect guy.
I was at his wedding.
Yeah, you. Nobody else could direct it like Fisher because I knew he knew me. He was an actor. He was a director, a producer. He understands the whole show business thing.
The only thing I didn't have the experience with was getting married.
But I figured Fish would be the guy who could really help me put it all together and keep it honest and keep it real.
He's revealing some very honest feelings and emotions that he's currently going through.
I'm not quite sure if it's because I'm very masochistic. I mean, my biggest fear was Richard Pryor, and he always told it exactly how it happened to him.
His imitations are incredible. No one's seen him do Al Pacino, Steven Seagal, Harrison Ford.
Hollywood, for the people who aren't involved, I think it's going to be great. For the people who are mentioned, it may not be so great.
It's been fun because he's so great to work with. He's a pain in the ass, but he's great to work with.
I have an authority issue.
I approach it by making sure that he cries every morning.
It's been fun. We crack each other up a lot, and,
we're hard
on each other.
Too.
We roast each other.
Yeah, a lot of roasting.
The busiest white guy I've ever seen. The women, the documentaries.
Hey, hey.
Stop.
Since I've been working with John, I've developed a bit of a...
Ulcer.
But I love working with him.
Luckily, he's a lot of fun, so we spend a lot of time together. He's cheap, but...
What?
But so am I, so that's great. So
we're both cheap.
He's much cheaper than me, by the way. He looks at the price of the pancakes. If blueberries are extra, sometimes he won't take them.
It's been an interesting bond between the three of us. We are... very compatible. We all understand what we're trying to do. We don't want to do each other's jobs. I think that's the best part of it all. And we've gotten along incredibly well.
I mean, I think Arnold's one of the best producers I've ever worked with. I mean, he really respects the artist. He really understands the process and the journey, how you have to protect it.
And he's really cheap like us.
Right, that's right. That's true, he is cheap.
We could be the three cheapest people in all the world, but cheap in a good way. The show is a journey. It has a beginning, a middle, and an end. It's not a stand-up, and you are truly moved by the time you leave it.
I think everybody will dig it because it's a guy's struggle with his artistry, with his life. It's not like a Latino play. It's not like a Jewish play. It's not like a black play. It's for everybody.
Very exciting. I can't wait.